Just to the west of central London, behind this public house, lies an unexpected and tranquil oasis, surrounded by its peaceful churchyard. St. Mary's Perivale has escaped plagues, famines, wars, and developers for nearly 900 years. Acquired in 1976 by a charity set up for the purpose, it has become one of the most important classical music venues in Britain. We're too small for orchestras, but our acoustic is perfect for chamber music and recitals. Until recently, we were welcoming audiences to 3 concerts each week.
Of course, that's all changed now, but we're determined to continue. We've got a full programme of live stream concerts, which will continue until life returns to normal. We need to support our musicians, and we need to look after this historic and beautiful building. So enjoy the concert, and please consider donating via our website. Thank you very much. Afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to St. Mary's Perivale. It's the last Tuesday of our series, so it's time for a piano recital. And it gives me huge pleasure this afternoon to welcome Artur Hafman, who's a wonderful pianist from Poland, who's just finished studying at the Royal College and actually lives in Ealing, which is nice. And you can read all about him on the webpage on our website. And it's a lovely program of favorite Chopin piano music, starting off with the Funeral March Sonata and going on from there to include the third ballad and the heroic Polonaise, etc. You're in for a treat. I'll get off the stage. Huge pleasure to welcome Artur Hafman to play for us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed that full hour of Chopin masterpieces as much as I did. It was quite wonderful. I think Polish pianists have the edge in Chopin. They sense these mazurkas and things in a way that non-Poles don't quite the same. Perhaps that's me not founded on very much, but it's brilliant playing. Thank you very much, Arto, for a lovely afternoon's music. And as always, if you'd like to show your appreciation via our donations page, the PayPal facility, that'd be very much appreciated. As always, all the money goes to the musicians with a little bit to the overheads. And there's an extra concert tomorrow lunchtime with Julian Jacobson playing Beethoven Pathetique and then Opus 111. That's rounding off the Beethoven Piano Society of Europe's year-long survey of all the sonatas. And he was going to play it at St. James's Piccadilly. They've had to shut up shop because of the COVID restrictions. But it takes more than that to shut up St. Mary's Perivale. So instead, he's going to come and play it tomorrow at 1:10, 10 past one, the same time it would have been at St. James's Piccadilly, to round off a momentous year for Beethoven, Piano Society of Europe, momentous year for us all. And actually, tomorrow is supposedly Beethoven's birthday. Actually, I don't think they're quite sure when it was. They know he was baptized, but not he was born. But they seem to think that it might have been tomorrow, 16th of December. So that's another reason to tune in to hear Julian Jacobson, a very well-known and very well-respected pianist, playing here. And then we've got one more concert on Sunday, the Greers, Indira Greer, cello, and Francis Greer on piano. Then we pack up for a fortnight, and then we've got about 50 concerts lined up for the first half of next year. Regardless of the virus, we will keep going. Thank you very much for being with us this afternoon, and good afternoon.